Yo, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to a new video of This Game World. Today we can do another battle with the NTW3 mod for Napoleon Total War. Today I'm joined with Kingston again. If you didn't see last battle, be sure to check it out. Also, be sure to check Kingston's channel out, and I'm gonna have both links in the description. I also will set a link in the description for Kingston's perspective of last battle. I don't know if he's gonna make one of this battle his perspective. But today I'm playing as Bavaria, and we're looking over my general's shoulder, look to my men who are watching out of the forests. Kingston is playing like France as Napoleon. We're fighting against the British and the Helder expedition. That's a combined Russian-British alliance or expedition force. Yo, everybody, I want to say I have hit the 25 subscribers. I'm really happy about it, and I'm really thankful for everybody who subscribed to me. I also want to thank everybody who is watching my videos, who is liking my videos, commenting on them, just sharing them. I really want to thank you. And I'm also recording this when I see I have 25 subs. I gonna put this in a video, I don't know which one yet. So the content you can expect in the near future are more battles of Napoleon Total War with Napoleon Total War 3 mod with Kingston. You can also expect a campaign of Napoleon Total War with Napoleon Total War 3 mod with Kingston. Maybe even where I play alone a single player campaign to stay in a Total War. I also can do Empire to War series. I can do two series, both with the Dwarf mod, but one is gonna be with the United Provinces, and that one gonna be in a Dutch, because I also do Dutch on my channel and I wanna get it back. I wanna get back to Dutch side of my channel, and I also can do one with the one campaign. With the US, and it's gonna be in English. Then you can also expect more Hearts of Iron. Also two series. One I already did with the First World War mod, the Great War mod, playing like Belgium. And one mod, gameplay where I'm gonna play with a friend of mine. And that one gonna be in Dutch. The First World War gameplay is in English, so if you want to check it out, be sure to do it. And I also gonna do in the First World War theme Verdun and Tannenberg. From those two games you can expect more videos of gameplay, and that's actually the upcoming content you can expect. So again, I want to thank all the people who hit the subscribe button, all 25 of you. I also want to thank the people who are watching my videos, and also who like the video and commenting and sharing. Before I forget, I want to say when we hit 50 subscribers, I'm gonna make a Discord for our community. So let us actually continue with the video, and I hope you enjoyed this one. So hit the like button. So be sure to hit the like button and subscribe. I see you on the other side. So we both spawned here, and so because this town or this city, yeah, this town is in the middle of us, we decided to join up our forces around this town, so we can take on the British who are coming from the forest, and the Helder expedition are coming from this open plain. If you saw last episode, you know the Russians had tons of cannoneers and they broke me. Guess what? The Russians have again tons of cannoneers. Another fun fact, They also belong to the Helda Expedition, so I'm facing them. I'm facing again tens of Canadiens. So Kingston, if you watch this, next time, no Russian, no Canadiens. Or not tens of Canadiens like you do with the Russians. But back to the... Oh my god, Kingshot. When we were playing, Kingston gave the British tons... an artillery battery of 11 cannons of rockets. So, yeah, like you saw, it's devastating. So now Kingston realized, shit, they have rockets. I can't move in this formation for long because it's gonna hurt me. We barely saw a glimpse of them. Yeah, now we see them, and Kingston said it, and I didn't actually care a lot because they are way up here, the bridge already down here. And from here, it looked like that they were going form up with the British, from my perspective. So, because the bridge were way closer, I moved up my horse artillery and form them up to support Kingston. And my regular artillery, I was moving up and trying to set down here so I could support and just to fight on my side, my front. The beginning can be kind of slow, but how I set up my men that they are walking out of the forest was actually an idea of Kingston. He had set his men. He has set his men in a line through the village with Napoleon somewhere here, watching over his men who are walking out of his town. Oh, and here is the first cavalry of the British from the 7th Coalition. These are Uhlanen, so they are Austrian. Wait, Austrian? No, they are German Lancer unit. And Kingston saw it before I did, so he sent some dragoons over. And I have some of my hussars ready to support him when they gonna clash. But I was not sure if they would go around or what to do, so I didn't really go close to them. And now we got another thing, because we didn't see anything except for the artillery. Yeah, for the artillery. I've set up my those rocks are really destructive. But because I saw the artillery, my 12 pounder artillery piece is just here. My Kev artillery is already here, so I thought, you know what, I'm gonna set up my artillery down here and let them. And so I have something to counter the Helda Expedition's artillery. Meanwhile, Kingston is preparing a defensive line against the British. And also, Kingston set his dragoons down here in case of another British attack or whatever. In the meantime, I'm setting up my line. I knew they were somewhere here, so I was thinking I couldn't set up along this. I could set up around here and use the river as a defensive line, because he can't cross over here because it's too steep. I can put men here and here, so they won't be able to go in between, and then just follow the river along until this blue painted river. For if you don't see it, it's just painted blue. So I thought that to represent rivers, so I'm gonna put one or two units down here, and the other one unit's gonna follow the river, and the other gonna follow this paint in river. In case you're gonna go around me, I have something to defend. It won't be the best thing, but it's good. And then I hear shots. Oh, no, I don't think so. The British made a huge mistake. Their rocket artillery is down here, exposed. No, I hear something, the cannons are opening fire. And the other mistake the British did was that general is all the way down here, not really protected. We don't see a lot, but they're not really protected. Meanwhile, the Held expedition, I really lost track of them, was really focusing on the British. I was more focused and I had some cav down here. I have one Ulanen cavalry unit or spare unit and hussars. And I was actually kind of focusing myself on the artillery that's somewhere here and the cavalry. Meanwhile, I was still preparing my defenses. And at 6 or 7 Canadian units, I didn't know I had so much. So I had quite a lot of reserves. And yeah, the French cav is moving in, trying to take out this artillery piece. But the British have sent its own cavalry to support their artillery. We are fighting against AI again because we're both new. Kingston has some campaigns with this mod. This is my second battle and the second time I play this mod. So yeah, we're gonna do some PvP battles later on, but for now it's just AI. And they broke the artillery piece. So you will see some big mistakes like this artillery piece, the generals alone, and the other artillery piece down here. The AI difficulty is on expert, so I was kind of freaking out because Russians, tons of Canadiers, I didn't trust it. And now I said to Kingston, hey Kingston, maybe you can go for the artillery, it's all by its own. And you see, I was already moving up my cav. And Kingston was... Oh my god, it's just really looking badass, in my opinion. Oh, I'm just gonna take a lot of screenshots. Oh yeah, and I have one militia unit. And I put them back here on the street. Just in case, if they're gonna flank around through the forest, I have some defenses. You can see that I have 4 units here. I'm gonna put 2 units around this forest line. So I have some defenses down here that I won't be flanked that easily. This militia unit is just in case they wanna go through the forest, I have something. And now here is there artillery again. And I didn't really like it. And I didn't realize I have my cannon boat. Excuse me, they are both able to fire, but I didn't allow them to fire. And on Kingston's side, it's really gonna hit off soon. Oh, the cannons in the background just sounds amazing. And here the French of Kingston is opening fire on the British. I hope. But they shouldn't do it as well. One buttons. Oh. Okay, I tried to get a nice volley in here, but I failed. Oh yeah, now it's gonna go. I think this game hates me. But soon all the reloading guys will open up. Oh my god. I spam my screenshot button so I can take some time. Just because the rocks are coming out from behind the trees. Oh, it looks so gorgeous actually. and actually does it. It does a bit of damage. Not that much. But Kingston's now removing his retreating his skirmishers. It doesn't tactical retreat, so he did some volleys to damage the British, but the British are now coming way too close. Oh, I see on the mini map that the cavalry is about to charge. I was moving up my Ulanen to a bit closer, I can react faster. Also, this gave you time bring out behind, setting behind my infantry in case that they will charge this Attila at this cav unit. This cavalry unit, they won't be that easy to get in. And I still forgot to allow my units to fire at will, so they are just standing here doing nothing. Both of them. And on the other side, it's about to become dirty. Whoa. Kingston made a kind of error. He put his grenadier unit and elite unit in the front line. I don't know what his tactic is. Wait a minute. That looks awesome. But I can give you a tip. Elite units like grenadiers, or really elite units like the old guard for France, put them a little back, you know, put them in reserve. And British unit, I think it's just, yeah, that's a regular line infantry, I guess. Put them on in front. Is that standing something on the flag? I think. Now we see tons and tons of cavalry units. I was actually watching over to Kingston's battle, and Kingston saw it and he said it. He was moving up his cavalry units, and when he said it, I saw it and moved my cavalry unit on. This infantry unit saw it as well and was firing. In this unit, I did the stupid thing. I let them deploy already this thick, this linear infantry. Instead of keep them in column so they can move faster and let them use the road. But this unit is just a unit gonna stand here, stand here to defend this flank a bit. And after this victory, I moved up this unit to attack the artillery. Will I get prevent the fire by this? No, okay, that's good. Kingston's unit came way too late and rushed through it, and I wasn't sure if I think friendly fire. I got killed by friendly cav charge. But now I opened, let my artillery fire, and you see just tons of units. Grenadiers, musketeers, 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 Highlanders. Grenadiers. These grenadiers. King's own line, I think. Guard units. I don't know what this unit is. But this unit. And line infantry. This is also line infantry, I think. And these are the general staff. And some lights. And they came out of nothing. This cav unit I'm bringing back soon, normally. I hope. I don't know. I hope I bring him out there. I have my Ulanen here, my Hussars over here. Oh, another attack of the British. And look at this battlefield. Kingston took out the rocket artillery, and I said, hey, Kingston, maybe you can attack the general of the British, because he's all alone. Kingston was kind of busy supporting me at the time, but he said, good idea. And after that, he charged the British general, but first he supported me in this clash. It just look one massive line, the bridge attacking. It looks... This mod really makes the Napoleon Total War a total other game. You can call this mod the Napoleon Total War 2. Because it's so good. I don't know why they call it Napoleonic Total War 3 mod. Maybe there are two others before or another one. I know, but this mod makes amazing. It gives you really more strategy to allow to use. We're not playing against AI, so don't expect too much. And still, I'm afraid of this entire unit. My cans are firing, I hope. Yeah, they're firing, they're reloading. They are still doing nothing. I actually realized it very late in the game. But I have to say, I like this map. Yeah, the British are firing. Kingston is now gonna try to kill the general. But you have one big city down here, and then spread out over the map, you have some small villages. It's something I makes the map really beautiful. So we defeated the British cavalry attack. Kingston is moving up his cavalry to the road. He defeated with no loss. With barely any losses from his own unit. He defeated the Hog Artillery, and now he's moving up, line up on the road to move faster and then attack the general. And already the bridge are failing. At least the units try to attack the artillery, but the artillery opened fire before they could get there and they got crushed, and they are retreating. They're out of the battle. On my side, still nothing is happening, so I'm not really focusing. But now I saw most of the death forces are focusing more on this side. I hoped that they would go for this line, but they are an expert, so they're gonna fight where it's the most weak defense. At the same time, Kingston is moving up his cavalry unit for this light unit. And now I opened up my horse artillery, and I... What? I don't know why I did this. But I saw they are moving more troops towards this side, so I decided to move up some of my reserve units more to this side in case I have to retreat. Kingston is now attacking the general. It's really hard to see because of the forest. And the British general broke. And now they got killed. So there were already a lot of units breaking, and now we get a mess out of the British. At this time, I saw all the units are coming towards this river front. So I ordered my men to change positions to more go follow the river and really get an angle here. Or get a little bandit. I changed my lines a bit here. The British are actually out of the battle. They have some bit fighting them, but they will get crushed very soon. Kingston trying to do as much damage as he could, but the enemy forms crashed, so he didn't really do it, but he took out light infantry, and I'm happy about that. So now Kingston's retreating. My man, I set them to follow the river, but now I changed their position, so we have more firepower down here. You can see I forming up my army like this. I don't remember why. The British are really just with 5 units left in the battle. And now Kingston is moving up his reserve forces to go and support me on my front. Because my men are opening fire. And yeah, the Held Expedition doesn't give a shit. They're just walking. My men are still forming up on this side and they're gonna be soon reformed. They have lost quite some men, even I killed quite some of them. They still don't give a shit, they're still walking through. And now Kingston said, hey, maybe you have to retreat to this hilltop. But I was looking at this moment to his side. Oh. To his side, and yeah, they're done. He's moving up even more units towards my side. I'm moving my cavalry up here so I can fling them around if needed. And this here, yeah, this unit just gonna walk through like nothing happens. I broke one of their units. Excuse me. I broke one of their units, but this unit is just walking through like they don't care. They just lost 7 men. 8 men. They really like they don't care, but the others are just walking close to each other, coming in. Kingston is coming for this unit, so I won't be flanked. And now I realized, shit, I have to retreat. But you can already see, they are Canadiens. So I was kind of fucked. So this. Why is this unit doing nothing? Why is this Linien Infanterie doing nothing? Yeah, but now we got in a melee situation down here. I'm retreating this unit because of them. And I formed them up alongside this river, hoping they get some volleys off over here. I totally forgot about this cavalry unit, so I moved up my other units. My militia is now moving up to support on this front. All my reserve units I'm moving up, but I don't gonna use them all. This unit I'm just gonna sacrifice him because they won't be able to retreat, they will break. Kingston broke the other light units. Not an other Canadier units. I'm moving up my cav. Now when Kingston is now with the first. Yeah, the first unit has now arrived. But you can already see the slaughter of this battle. I mean, this just a start. And you hear one of my units is retreating. Now I'm using two Grenadier units. I'm gonna set them up alongside this river and let them just open fire on the Russians. This unit's gonna stand alongside here, and this unit's gonna follow the river as well, and just let them fire over the river. And reinforcements have arrived of the French. But I didn't really need their help. I was really doing everything good, except for this cavalry unit. I totally forgot about it. I was focused on my reinforcements to set up alongside the river. Did they came back for a moment? I think so. Oh no, they are breaking. And I was trying to set up a defensive line, but I fucked up. So now I try to move these guys over the setup here, defensive line. But suddenly I see that cavalry is moving towards another unit. So I let them stop, form up, I change their direction to look. I let them just open fire. These three Canadier units are Linen Infantry, Linen Infantry, Linen Infantry. Okay, so I had some more regular units just moving up. I had less grenadiers than I thought. Then it's simple set. But here I'm already winning, and it looks just, I think, just tons of clean shots because it looks badass. Here, I'm shooting on my own men, but they're already breaking, so I just execute the cav on down here. I'm just shooting on the cav point blank range. Excuse me. And I broke the cav, so now I'm just gonna reform my lines again. And I saw an opportunity to try to take down the other artillery, but I'm caught on some musketeers. Tons of breaking down on the Russian side. Kingston is moving up three other units to form alongside this French unit. And here we're just holding them. From this point, just the point of no retreat. Yeah, one bullet landed really close to my general. I didn't like it, so I moved them a little back. I'm moving this unit up, but I don't know why. The British are showing some resistance of being totally removed to the battlefield, but still King's Nest moved up. New units, these units are also coming towards me. The artillery is, I think, also coming towards me. No, they're standing still. So yeah, the bridge are totally off the map. Now only the Helder Expedition is here. And they were winning so badly, I decided to move my men up, and I had some forces to stand here looking towards this. And all, those are better trained line infantry, and I couldn't set them looking the other direction. And you can see we're totally surrounding them. Here on my man, just down here. I'm moving up my other candy unit a bit closer and just next to them, just get them really in an angle. And then the French also going around, so yeah, we really broke them. One British unit remaining. Yeah, they don't gonna make it. And Kingston couldn't wait, so it just gave him a cold steal. I took a screenshot of it, and just look at the carnage. Look at the carnage. And the battle is not over yet. And now my units are deploying and getting ready for the first line. The second line is, I already deployed them, my bad, but the battle is over. You can see now in the minimap all the British have broken. The only bridge that are remaining are from the Helder Expedition. Yeah, I see one bridge unit, three British units. Okay, now the only one musketeer unit of the Russians are remaining through, but I saw that moved up. I saw that King's side of it, and I already moved my men up. Right now, just ending the battle. You already see what I want to do. Fully surround them on this side of the river. These units already getting ready for deployment on this side to cover their backs. I didn't know if it was smart, but quite some units are retreating this side, and this turtle piece came already back. I neither want that, so I didn't want them to get sandwiched, get stuck in between two units, so I moved them up. And here the battle is just over. Everything is dead. The carnage is huge. This is just... Yeah, you need to shut up, and because spell is over. And tons of British are laying down here. And my man's still fine when retreating British units. All units have were broken, only here some units that are still active fighting. And now you can see I moved one unit up to set on this line for all units that came back. On this riverbed for all units that came back. Kingston is making his artillery ready to fire on the retreating units. So is infantry is just moving up to support to guard the artillery. And now you can see what I was trying to do with this unit. With these three units. You see this one already forming up. And this battle is over. One rich unit there, but battle is over. I deployed tons of... You can see, Kingston and I deployed together in the 4,000 units. Together we lost about 500, a little more than 500 units. The enemy deployed like 3,500-ish. Around 3,500, and they lost in the 2,000s. They just lost tons and tons of units. And I hope you enjoyed this battle, because this was it. I know fighting against AI isn't that challenging and spectacular. So after this battle, Kingston and I were thinking about scenarios we could do, like a Soviet attack on the Second World War, but in Napoleon Total War. So tons of militia or all cheap shit units to get a massive army against a regular / elite army that we were. And we're gonna fight, and Kingston and I gonna be German states fighting against Russians. So you can do things like that, or defending against more AI and more enemies than we have. Like for example, three enemy armies, all three controlled by AI, but regular armies with some artillery, some cavalry, some regular infantry, maybe some militia, and some elite units. And so will our armies be. And think about that kind of scenarios, maybe use an other mod that has this, that has historical battlefields of the Napoleon era in this. So we really think about scenarios to do. If you want to see a certain scenario, it can be to against place, can be against AI. Let us know. Tell about what scenario you were thinking about in the factions. We will see what we can do. And be sure that I can do more with Kingston. I'm now just playing battles, but we're talking about and trying to get a campaign up and running. We can do together. And maybe we can do PvP battles next time. And I hope you enjoyed. And I hope you enjoyed this battle, because this is the video. I really actually enjoyed this battle. I'm now looking back. Just look at the carnage on my front for the beginning. Just that everywhere. That is everywhere. Then we're gonna go to Kingston's side. You see where the British were. You also see where the French stood. The difference is just huge. Especially here on Kingston's front. You see the taking force and defending force. And on my front, I wouldn't call this a battle anymore. Well, I will just call this an execution, a slaughter. I don't think I know most people lost their lives down here. Oh. It's so fun to play. I hope you enjoyed it too, because this was the battle and the episode. So if you enjoyed the video, be sure to hit the thumb up. Don't forget to subscribe to see more and hit the bell notification to stay up to date. And I hope I see you next time. Bye bye.
Farouche.